Hi friends, this is Preeti. Today I'm going to discuss about tannins. So tannins are nothing but polyphenolic compounds, and they are classified into three types based on the dry distillation process, based on the behavior on dry distillation. Okay, the three types are hydrolyzable tannins, condensed tannins, and pseudo tannins. Hydrolyzable tannins means the tannins which get hydrolyzed by acids or enzymes into gallic acid or ellagic acid, and further on dry distillation they give pyrogallol, and this pyrogallol when treated with the FeCl3 ferric chloride it gives a blue color. Then we can say that this is a hydrolyzable tannin. Okay, these are the examples. Okay, and here we can see condensed tannins, which are also called as non-hydrolyzable tannins or floba tannins or proanthocyanidins. Okay, in this the tannins, they are not hydrolyzed by acids or enzymes. Instead, they are polymerized or decomposed into the flobaphenes, which are insoluble in water, and they appear as brownish red in color. Okay, on dry distillation they give catechol, and when this catechol is treated with FeCl3 it shows brownish green color. Okay, just remember these products, final products. In hydrolyzable there is a gallic, ellagic, and then pyrogallol blue color, and in condensed flobaphenes, catechol, and brownish green color. Okay, and these are the examples. Here it is Ashoka, whereas here it is Arjuna. Okay, and pseudotannins, these are low molecular weight compounds and they do not obey gold bitter skin test. Examples: chlorogenic acid, which is present in coffee and Lux vomica, and ipecacuanic acid, and then catechins in coca. Okay, these examples are very important. In every classification, examples are very, very important. Okay, now we come to the properties. Tannins are present in a solution form in cell sap and a vacuole. Previously we have seen alkaloids and glycosides are solids, whereas tannins, they are present in a solution form in cell sap and vacuoles. They are also known as astringent substances. Astringent substance means the substance which combine to the tissue proteins and forms a precipitate. Okay, and the tannins are also used in medicines, like they are used as mild antiseptic and for the treatment of diarrhea, and for checking small hemorrhages. And also they are used in leather industry, where the skin of animals are treated with tannins to prevent the decaying of that skin. Okay, here tannins are colloidal solutions, nothing but they are non-crystalline substances, and they are high molecular weight compounds, whereas pseudotannins are low molecular weight. They are polyphenols and soluble in alcohol, glycerine, and dilute alkali, whereas insoluble in organic solvents except acetone. In acetone they are soluble. Okay, and the solution of tannin precipitates gelatin and alkaloids, whereas tannins are precipitated by salts of copper, tin, lead, and a strong potassium dichromate solution. And also one more is there, which is 2% solution of phenazone. Okay, by these three methods tannins are precipitated, and these tannins show colored reactions with iron salts. So previously we have seen hydrolyzable has shown a blue color, whereas condensed has shown brownish green color. So here we can see with FeCl3 salt it show bluish or a brownish green, and with the potassium ferric cyanide it shows deep red. Okay, that's it. This is the classification and properties of tannins. We'll meet in the next video with resins. Thank you so much for watching my video.